Hey, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of a design or text burned into wood. I provided this image of wood texture that you could download. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click like if you like this video. Thank you. Open a high contrast, black and white graphic that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. With your Move tool active, drag it onto the tab of the wood texture. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold the Shift key as you drag it down and release. Pressing Shift kept our graphic centered over the wood. You could also type in black text, which will work just as well. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner. In version CC 2019 and later, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it in or out. In earlier versions, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it. Then press Enter or Return, or click the check mark at the top. Make a new layer below the active layer by Ctrl or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with white, but before we do, check your foreground and background colors. If they're not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since white is our background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Shift-click your graphic or text to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command E to merge them together. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click the eyeball icon next to the copy to hide the layer, and make the original layer active. Open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Ctrl or Command click the thumbnail of any of the channels to make a selection of the black graphic or text. Open back the Layers panel and press the Delete key to delete everything white. Make the top layer visible and active. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. Expand it 1 pixel and fill it with black by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete. Then deselect it. Invert the image by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Go to Filter, Stylize, and Wind. The method is wind, and the direction can be either from the right or left. Click OK. Repeat the filter twice more by pressing Ctrl-Alt-F on Windows or Command-Ctrl-F on a Mac twice. Go back to Filter, Stylize, and Wind. Tick the other direction. Click OK and repeat the filter twice more. Invert your image. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. Open Levels by pressing Ctrl or Command L. In the Output Black Level field, type in 72. Change the blend mode to color burn. Reduce its opacity to 60%. Hide the middle layer and Ctrl or Command click the graphic or text to select its shape. Make a new layer. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 2 pixels and fill it with black. Then deselect it. Reduce the fill to 40%. Doing this reduces the opacity of the layer, as well as the layer styles we'll be adding to it. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is outer bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 50%. The direction is up, the size is 20 pixels, and soften it 0 pixels. Uncheck Use Global Light. The angle is 130 degrees, and the altitude is 48 degrees. The gloss contour is linear. The highlight mode is irrelevant since its opacity is 0%. The shadow mode is linear burn, the color is black, and the opacity is 22%. Click Inner Shadow. The blend mode is linear burn, the color is black, and the opacity is 10%. Uncheck Use Global Light. The angle is 147 degrees, the distance is 5 pixels, the choke is 0, and the size is 50 pixels. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.